Howdy, everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down the Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. I wonder how many of you know what a valuable part this original malted milk plays in weight control. Many specialists in dieting recommend Horlicks because it is a well-balanced, nourishing food. Its use enables you to cut down safely on your regular food, with a consequent loss of weight. Here's what thousands do. Every noon, they make a glass full of Horlicks at home or in the school, office, or shop, in place of a heavy, hard-to-digest lunch. Horlicks, a nourishing, sustaining food, does not contain the excess calories of a heavy meal. Since excess calories are a common cause of excess weight, this plan is very effective in cutting down those excess pounds. And what's even more important, it's essentially safe. You can't afford to risk reducing at the cost of your health. So try the safe, effective Horlick plan. All you need is a package of Horlicks in either natural or chocolate flavor. And this you can get, you know, from your dealer. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. When Lum planned to kidnap Abner so that he might make a fake rescue in order to become a hero in the eyes of his fellow townsmen, little did he realize the complications it might involve. While Abner is hiding over at Lum's house taking life easy, Lum is forced to join the many searching parties that have been organized to scour the surrounding mountains in a futile effort to rescue the missing Abner. As we look in on our friends today, we find Lum has just returned to his house after another useless searching expedition. Listen.
Well, where in the world have you been all night? I've been worried to death about you.
Well, I've been traipsing all over these mountains looking for you and whoever kidnapped you.
You mean with that searching party?
Yeah, we walked all night long. Covered every foot of ground twixt here and Hogjaw Valley. Just got in a while ago.
Where?
Look at them clothes. My night tore them off of myself going through the brush there. Yeah, I hadn't noticed that coat button missing there. Happened when I done that.
Well, I do know. And you was knowing all the time that I was sitting right here in your house.
Yeah, that's what makes me get so mad. But I've got to make out like I'm uneasy about you so they won't suspicion that I know anything about it.
I don't get that so good or on you.
It ain't no laughing matters, I'll tell you that right now. Let me slip these shoes off. My feet is about to kill me.
Well, no wonder. Them shoes there look like they weigh yonder too little for you.
I reckon they are too little. I wear 11s and these are size 8s. Just look how them feet is swole up there. You might not see them take a deep breath when I slip them shoes off.
Well, natural. Why don't you get your shoes to fit you?
Well, you know them tracks we made outside your window the night we kidnapped you so they could see the kidnappers took you out through the window.
Yeah, that was your idea, making them tracks.
Well, the idea was all right, but your woman, Elizabeth, got out there and measured the tracks. She says one of them's yours all right, but if she can find anybody with feet that'll fit them other tracks, she'll have the kidnapper.
Yeah, and she would, too.
And that's just the reason I'm wearing these little bitty shoes, too. If she measures my feet, she can't lay it on to me.
Yeah, but you'll just ruin your feet wearing them things long.
Well, Grannies, I'd rather ruin my feet than to be sent to the penitentiary for kidnapping.
Oh, well, I don't think Elizabeth will ever suspicion that you had anything to do with
it. Yeah, it's just all you know about it. That woman of yours suspicions everybody. Every time she sees somebody with big feet, she makes them let them measure them.
Well, you better keep off your feet now, not do no more walking you have to then, Mom.
I can't keep off my feet. Every time I sit down to rest a minute, somebody come along organizing another searching party to go out in the mountains and look for you. And then, of course, I have to go with them.
Yeah, that's a shame.
Granny, these feet of mine ain't had a breathing test spell since we hid you out over here.
Well, the next bunch that comes by, Lum, well, you can just stay here and I'll go in your place.
Well, you can't go. You're the one they're looking for, you and the kidnapper. Body can't go look for yourself.
Well, that's what you've been doing. You've been looking for the kidnapper, and you're the one that kidnapped me.
Granny, that's right, ain't it? Next time they want me to go, I'll just tell them. No, wait a minute here. That won't work. I wish to goodness I thought of some other way to make a hero out of myself. This is getting to be a nuisance.
Well, why don't we just go ahead and turn me loose, Lum? Study up some other way for you to make a hero out of yourself. I'm getting tired of sitting around over here all day by myself.
Well, we can't let you out now, Abner. Spoil everything. Folks here in the community are the worst to find out you ain't sure enough kidnapped now. After them traipsing all over these hills looking for you, they'd run me and you both out of town.
Well, I'll be glad when I can get home. See Elizabeth some more. Sit down to some more of her cooking. This kidnapping idea of yours, making a hero out of yourself, but it's going to starve me to death if you don't hurry up and rescue me.
Starve?
Yes, sir.
For goodness sake, you've had enough in the last few days to found an ordinary human. I was just noticing that stack of empty cans back there in the kitchen yesterday. Looks like you've been eating over here for a couple of months.
Well, I sat all day Saturday by myself while you was out looking for me. I got so lonesome I had to do something for amusement, so I just ate all day.
Yeah, this kidnapping was running into money. I thought I had enough canned goods laid in here to keep me half the winter.
Well, I've got to eat, Lum. I can't just sit over here and starve myself.
Well, you ain't. Don't you worry. I bet you put on 10 pounds in the last 2 days. Your folks won't know you when I take you home. Here, Elizabeth's worried to death about you, and you're better off than you ever was.
Yeah, I hate that part of it. Her little Pearl grieving herself to death over me. Poor little Pearl. I know she's just worried to death, scared something's happened to her papa.
Wait a minute, that's my ring. Be quiet now.
Yeah.
Hello?
This guy's home, that's what I was.
This is him? Who is this, Elizabeth?
Well, Elizabeth.
I thought it sounded like you.
God bless her heart. Bless her little heart.
Why, sort of tired right now, Elizabeth. I just got back a while ago. A bunch of us was out in the mountains looking for Abner.
Fine a woman if ever God bless.
No, Mom, not a sign of no kind. It just looks like he's evaporated all of a sudden. Well, now, I wouldn't worry about him, Elizabeth. Chances are he'll be showing up now in the next day or so.
Poor.
I told you I'd find him, and I aim to do it, too. You can depend on that. You're aiming on doing what? Well, I don't know about that, Elizabeth. I believe if you just wait, I can find him myself and save you all that money. Ah. Well, of course, do as you like. Well, what time are you aiming on taking the ransom money over there? Ah. Yeah, well, all right, Elizabeth. I hope they bring him back all right. All right. Goodbye.
Now, what's that about the ransom, Lum?
There's your woman. She says she's going to take the $50 ransom money over and hide it on the steps at the schoolhouse like we told her to in that note.
Well, good. Now I can go home.
No, you can't go home. We're not after the ransom money.
Huh?
I've got to rescue you first. That's the whole idea for the kidnapping.
Well, now, don't let her put that money under there, then, for somebody else about get it, Lum. I'll just be out $50.
Well, I can't stop her if she finds...
Well, you can go over there and get the money, can't you?
No, if she finds the money gone, she'll think the kidnapper's got it, and she'll be expecting you back.
Well, now, me or you one's got to go after that $50. I'll be dad blamed if I'm going to leave it laying around over there under them steps and let somebody else.
All right, all right. I'll flip over there tonight and get it and turn it over to you. I reckon they'll just think the kidnapper's double-crossed her. That won't hurt nothing, no way, I reckon.
And I still don't see why you don't rescue me today and get this thing over with.
Well, I'm just as anxious to get you back to your folks as you are, Abner. I ain't had a good night's sleep since the thing started. But the longer we wait, the better it'll be. The more we let folks worry, the bigger hero it'll make out of me when I rescue you. It'll be the talk of the community.
Yeah.
I'll fix up a big story about how I whipped a whole gang of desperadios and returned you to your loved ones and all that stuff. We'll both have to tell the same story, though.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Somebody at the door. Get out of here, Abner. Get back there in the bedroom and hide under the bed. Quick.
Well, I don't talk to them all day.
Shh. Come in, come in. Well, howdy, Dick.
Yeah, howdy, Lon. Just over to Abner's house. His wife has borrowed the money somewhere for that ransom. She's going to put the $50 on the steps over today.
Yeah, she just now called and told me about it, Dick.
Well, I thought I'd better tell you before you start out with another searching party.
Yeah. Tell you the truth, I believe she's making a mistake putting up the money that way at this time, but I still think I can find Abner.
Well, this is a good way to catch a kidnapper, go along. We were going to have Moe's Moose hiding down at the schoolhouse with a shotgun.
With a shotgun?
Yeah. So when those kidnappers go to look under the steps for the ransom, why, Moe's can let them have a load of buckshot.
Well, now, wait a minute. I don't know about that, Dick. I granny somebody might get hurt, get their shooting around that way.
Well, that's exactly what we want. We want to catch these kidnappers, Lum. We want to catch them right away and get Abner back.
And I don't see no use in that. If we can get Abner back, that's the main thing.
Oh, yeah, sure. But if we can catch those kidnappers, why, the thing for us to do is to make an example out of them, too. Everybody in town's brought up over them.
Yeah, I know they're. But I don't think we ought to be too hard on them.
Well, I don't know. I've talked to quite a few today, Lum, and they're even talking about lynching them if they catch them.
Lynching them?
Yeah, I told them, though, if we catch whoever did it, why, we ought to turn them over to the authorities and let the law take its course. That's the proper thing to do.
Yeah, we don't want no hangings around here, I know that. That's one thing I wouldn't stand for a minute. I'm the justice of the peace here, and I wouldn't stand for it at all.
Well, no, we want to stop that if we can, Lum. But still, on the other hand, we want to see them get what's coming to them. I want to see them get the full penalty of the law. Take it to court and stick them the full penalty.
Yeah, reckon so. Trouble is, old Dick, it might be one of our leading citizens that done it. Can't tell about them things.
Well, I don't care who it is. They'll all look alike to me, Lum. Anybody low down enough to kidnap a harmless old fellow like Abner doesn't deserve any consideration. I'd feel the same way about it if it turns out to be my best friend that did it.
Mm.
I'd feel the same way about it if it was you that did it, even, Lum.
If it was me?
Yes, sir.
You ain't accused me?
No, I'm not accusing. I just say I would feel that way about it.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Well, that's fine, Dick. I hope we catch him.
Well, he'll be caught. Don't you worry about that. We found another clue over a while ago.
Another clue?
Yeah, we found a coat button that one of them lost when he was pulling Abner out of the window.
A coat button? Hey, Granny.
Oh, what a tangled web we weave when first we practice to deceive. And now, ladies and gentlemen, attention motorists and late vacationists. We're going to hear from Mrs. Emma Foreman of Indianapolis, Indiana.
We enjoy Lum and Abner, Horlicks, and your announcer each evening as we are eating our dinner. Consequently, when we planned an automobile trip to Cleveland, we thought a bottle of Horlicks tablets an essential. From Indianapolis to Cleveland is a long trip for one lady and two wiggly, diggly children. Well, 120 miles from Cleveland, I became so sleepy I was afraid to trust myself to drive, and the children were tired and cross. So I stopped the car in a small Ohio town, and we all ate some tablets. Then on we went, rested and happy, arriving in Cleveland in plenty of time for dinner. In the future, we're always going to have Horlicks tablets along on our trip.
Well, thanks for your letter, Mrs. Foreman. You know, there are scores of other uses for Horlicks tablets. They're fine not only for motoring, but for golfing, shopping, when you're working around the house, or for your youngsters when they ask for something to eat between meals. These tablets can be bought, of course, at your dealers in both natural and chocolate flavors. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all goodbye until tomorrow at the same time.